This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a powerful customizable poster. I provided this background, an image of a bodybuilder, and the font I used in the intro called Aldo the Apache. Their links are in my video's description or project files. Before we begin, smash that subscribe button so you know as soon as I upload new Photoshop tutorials. If you want to use a different photo, the result will look best if your subject is dramatically lighted so it has plenty of shadows and highlights. First, let's make a copy of it so we always have the original. Press Ctrl or Command J. If you're using a different photo, remove its color by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift U. To automatically adjust its brightness and contrast, go to Image and Auto Contrast. Next, we'll remove the subject from its background by making a selection around the subject. There are many ways to make selections, and I've covered them in hundreds of my tutorials. So, to save time, I already created the selection. To use it, open the Channels panel. If you don't see it, go to Window and Channels. Control or Command click the Alpha 1 thumbnail to make a selection of its shape. Open back the Layers panel and press Control or Command J to cut and copy it onto its own layer. Press V to open your Move tool and drag the subject onto the tab of the background. Without releasing your mouse or pen, drag it down and release. To resize it, open your Transform tool by pressing Control or Command T. Go to a corner and drag it in or out. To reposition it, go inside the bounding box and drag it. Then press Enter or Return. To center it vertically, press Ctrl or Command A to select our visible document and click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we'll add a fiery glow on the wall behind our subject. We'll make a new layer below the active layer by Ctrl or Command clicking the New Layer icon. Click the foreground color to open the color picker. Pick a bright red color. Open your brush tool and brush picker. Pick a soft round brush. Make its size 800 pixels, the hardness 0%, and the opacity and flow 100%. Center your brush vertically behind your subject and click once. Change its blend mode to overlay and reduce its opacity to 50%. Open your transform tool and go to the top middle anchor point. Press and hold the shift key as you drag the top down approximately this much. Go to a middle side anchor point and press and hold Alt or Option plus Shift as you drag the sides out approximately this much. Then press Enter or Return. Next, we'll add a shadow under our subject. Make a new layer and press D on your keyboard to revert your foreground and background colors to black and white respectively. Black is now our foreground color. Press B to open back your brush tool. To reduce its size, make sure your caps lock key is off and press the left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush under your subject. It doesn't have to be perfect, just brush over areas of the floor you think would have shadows cast by the subject. Change its blend mode to multiply and reduce its opacity to 90%. Make a new layer. In this layer, we'll place our text. Open your horizontal type tool and type picker. Pick a font. I'll be using Aldo the Apache, which I provided if you'd like to use it. I'll make its size 225 points, but feel free to adjust its size depending on the font you choose and the amount of characters in your text. I'll make the aliasing sharp and center alignment. Click on your image and type out your text. To reposition it, go to the right of your text and drag it. If you have two or more lines, highlight all the lines and go to Window and Character. Drag the scrubby slider of the leading icon to the left or right to adjust the amount of space between your lines of text. If you want to italicize it, click the italic icon. We can close the character panel now. To adjust the spacing between two specific characters, known as kerning, click between those characters and press and hold Alt or Option as you press the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. By the way, the name for adjusting the spacing between a range of characters is tracking. To center your text, open your Move tool, and as before, press Ctrl or Command A, and click the Align Vertical Centers icon. Then deselect it. Reduce its fill to 0%. This makes our text invisible, but it'll retain the full visibility of the layer styles we add to it. Double-click an empty area of the text layer to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is Inner Bevel, and the technique is Chisel Hard. The depth is 100%, and the direction is up. The size is 2 pixels, and the soften is 0. If Use Global Light is checked, deselect it. In case you're wondering what the heck is Global Light, it's used to set one master lighting angle that is then available in Drop Shadow, Inner Shadow, and Bevel and Emboss. If Use Global Light is deselected, the lighting angle we set applies only to that specific effect. The angle is minus 135 degrees, and the altitude is 60 degrees. The gloss contour is linear. The highlight mode is linear dodge. Its color is white, and the opacity is 90%. The shadow mode is linear burn. Its color is black, and the opacity is 100%. Click Inner Shadow. The blend mode is normal. The color is black, and the opacity is 100%. Use Global Light is unchecked. The angle is 47 degrees. The distance is 6 pixels. The choke is 0. And the size is 10 pixels. The contour is linear. Increase the fill to 25% and change the blend mode to linear burn. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.